Hello, everybody. Welcome to the machine learning attack series. Today we're going to talk about image scaling attacks. What is an image scaling attack? So at a very simple level, the idea is that you have a large image, and within that large image you encode a smaller image, and then when some process on the machine resizes that image to a certain size, the second image becomes actually visible. So it fundamentally changes what image is being presented by the computer. So it's not just like a small variation, it's a fundamentally different image. And how does this apply to machine learning, you might ask? So the idea is that the attacker basically crafts a malicious input image and ties this desired target image within that larger image. Usually has to be about 2 to 10 times larger the original image than the image you hide inside. And then when the server processes that image, right? In machine learning, there's always the step of pre-processing, so the image gets resized, so it is a well-defined size that is then r put into the neural network for processing. And this means that the image that is actually being processed by a neural network is a different image than the server initially received by the client. So what is the outcome? The outcome is that a machine learning model might be trained to predict on a very different image that one might expect. So where is this possibly a problem? So looking at the various parts of the machine learning pipeline, right, there's from a machine learning point of view, there's two areas that are problematic. One is the training phase, where an adversary might try to poison the training set, the data that is be the neural network is being trained. Let's say you read in information from images from the internet, right? You read them in various sizes, but then they all have to be pre-processed and downsized to a certain size that all the images have the same size. And this is sort of where potentially poisoning can happen, that you do train on a very different image that you initially downloaded from the internet. The second step is after you deploy the model, right, an adversary might to try to perform an evasion attack. So they would query the model, with upload this big image to your machine learning model, and the server pre-processes it, resizes the image, and then a prediction is being made on this fundamentally different image. So these are sort of these two areas in machine learning. And if you follow up my blog series, I sort of show and walk you through some of these attacks in my Husky AI application. And the third scenario is actually doesn't have to do anything to do with machine learning. So the idea of hiding one image inside another image, right, this might have implications in a lot of other areas as well, where you might be able to secretly send messages, or you might be able to bypass certain filters and so on. So this is actually something, if you do bug bounty hunting, right, this is something to be aware of as well. So here is now the example. On the very left, you can see my original source image, and I used the code from Erwin Quering from the Technical University of Braunschweig, who does or did a lot of research in this area. And I then used this Husky image that I showed you earlier and hit that inside that image. On the right side, you can see the modified image, the attack image. And if you look very, very closely, you can see all these little pixels in the sky that actually forms. If you look very closely, you can actually see there's a shape even that is visible. But if you don't pay close attention, it's basically invisible. And this is then what turns into the Husky if it's downsized to a small image. And here's now the example where I loaded it up in a Jupyter notebook, and the first image that is being read, I just displayed on the screen, right? And you can see it's the original image taken from Vienna. And the second image is being resized. So I use OpenCV and I do dot resize 228 by 128 pixels. And you can see when that is printed, drawn on the screen, becomes this Husky picture. So at this point, it's a fundamentally different image. And that's, I thought it's so cool that such an attack is so simple and has very drastic difference in outcome, right? If you look at the left and the right picture. That said, there's some simple mitigations. For instance, if you use the pillow and you use like the defaults, you won't be vulnerable. But if you use OpenCV, then you do call the resize method. By default, it does not do a safe interpolation. So you can specify when you call the resize method, you can specify interpolation, and for instance, use something else than like inter area, and then you won't be running into this problem. So be sure to be aware of that. Okay, so that was sort of it. A quick introduction to image scaling attacks. These really cool and powerful attack to be aware of. If you like the information, make sure to just subscribe to my channel. I'm gonna post and talk a lot about various hacking, red teaming, pen testing, machine learning topics. So stay tuned.